Welcome to Jeremy's IT Lab. This is a complete course for the CCNP ENCOR, Enterprise Core exam. In this video, we'll examine the STP states and timers we covered in the lecture video. This is the same topology that I showed a few times in the lecture video. Switch 1 is the root bridge. To confirm that, I'll hop on the CLI of switch 1. Enable, show spanning tree. So, switch 1 has a bridge priority of 1, and it says here that this bridge is the root. Okay, let's look at the lab instructions. So, we are going to use debug spanning tree event to confirm the STP states and timers. Let's get started with step 1. Disable and re-enable switch 5G01. Which STP states does it move through? How long does it take? And which state is it stable in? Okay, let's open the CLI of switch 5. Enable. First, I'll enable STP event debugging with debug spanning tree event. Next, let's check the role of switch 5G01 with show spanning tree. Okay, it's an alternate port, or I should say a non-designated port, because it's running PVST plus, not rapid PVST plus. So, what will happen when I disable and re-enable it? At first, it should become a designated port in the listening state. But after receiving a BPDU from switch 4, switch 5 will determine that G01 should be a non-designated port. It will then change its role to non-designated and immediately move it to the blocking state. Let's check. Conf T, interface G01, shutdown. I'll wait a couple seconds for the log messages to appear, and then I'll re-enable it with no shutdown. After initialization, which takes a second or two, it enters the listening state, and then soon after moves to the blocking state, after receiving a BPDU from switch 4. Okay, let's go back to the lab notes for step 2. It's the same deal as step 1, but this time for switch 4 G01. So let's go to the CLI of switch 4. Enable. First, let's enable STP event debugging. Debug spanning tree event. And then disable G01. Conf T, interface G01, shutdown. Wait a couple seconds for the log messages to appear. Notice that this time a topology change BPDU is sent. I'll cover the topology change process in the next video. Okay, let's re-enable it. No shutdown. After the port is enabled, it becomes a designated port in the listening state. I'll use do show spanning tree. As you can see here, it is still in the designated role, and it will proceed through the listening and learning states, spending 15 seconds in each, before moving to the forwarding state where it is stable. Switch 5G01 was able to move directly to the blocking state, after its role was decided, but a port can't move directly to the forwarding state, unless portfast is used. If you look at the timestamps of each state, you'll see that G01 was in the listening state for 15 seconds, the learning state for 15 seconds, and then finally entered the forwarding state. Let's return to the lab notes for step 3. Step 3 says to disable switch 4G00. What happens immediately after? And how long does it take for STP to reconverge? And then, re-enable it and confirm again. So let's go back to switch 4's CLI again. G00 is switch 4's root port. It's one path to the root bridge. It doesn't receive BPDUs on G01, since switch 5G01 is non-designated. So if switch 4G00 goes down, switch 4 will believe it has lost contact with the root bridge. It will then declare itself to be the root bridge, and start sending BPDUs of its own out of G01, which switch 5 receives. Because switch 4's bridge ID is lower than switch 1's, switch 4's BPDUs are inferior to switch 1's, and switch 5 ignores them. It still remembers the last BPDU from switch 1 that switch 4 forwarded to it, until the max age of that BPDU expires. That should take 18 seconds, because as we'll cover soon, when switch 4 forwards switch 1's BPDUs to switch 5, It forwards them with an age of 2, as we saw in the lecture video. Anyway, let's shut down G00 and confirm. Interface G00, shutdown. Okay, now switch 4 should declare itself the root bridge. Let's check with do show spanning tree. Indeed, it says this bridge is the root. It is now sending its own BPDUs to switch 5, and switch 5 is ignoring them. Note that this behavior is different in rapid STP. If these switches were running rapid STP, switch 5 would not ignore switch 4's inferior BPDUs, but rather start sending superior BPDUs to switch 4 immediately. So, as you can see here, it says STP VLAN 1 heard root, then switch 1's bridge ID, on G01. It supersedes this, which is switch 4's own bridge ID. And then it says, new root is, and this is switch 1's bridge ID. The top message formats it as 1- then switch 1's MAC address, but the second message formats it as 1, then switch 1's MAC address, for some reason. So that means that switch 4 has accepted switch 1 as the root bridge once again. Now let's check do show spanning tree again. And now, switch 4 G01 is a root port, not designated. It took about 18 seconds after I disabled G00 for G01 to become the root port. Note that it didn't have to transition through listening and learning. It simply changed its role from designated to root. Now, what will happen after I re-enable G00? At first, it should become a designated port in the listening state. And then, immediately after receiving a BPDU from switch 2, which could take up to 2 seconds, it should become switch 4's root port again. It will take 30 seconds for it to transition through the listening and learning states. Let's do it. No shutdown. As I said, G00 enters the listening state, and then after receiving a BPDU from switch 2, it becomes the root port again. But it will have to go through the listening and learning states before forwarding. Why didn't G01 have to go through them when it became the root port? It's because G01 was already in the forwarding state. It just had to change its role from designated to root. Anyway, after 15 seconds of listening and 15 seconds of learning, switch 4 G00 is in the forwarding state. Okay, let's return to the lab notes for step 4. It says to disable and re-enable switch 3 G01 and asks how long it takes to reach the forwarding state. Well, switch 3 G01 is connected to an end host, which doesn't use STP, of course. So what do you think will happen? Let's see. I'll go on the CLI of switch 3. Enable. First, enable STP event debugging. Debug spanning tree event. Now let's disable G01. Conf T, interface G01, shutdown. After the log messages appear, let's re-enable it. No shutdown. So, as always, it starts as a designated port in the listening state. And because it's not connected to a switch, it receives no BPDUs. So, it should remain a designated port, spending 15 seconds in the listening state, 15 seconds in the learning state, and then reach the forwarding state, where it is stable. Of course, you should use portfast on ports connected to end hosts, so they don't have to wait 30 seconds before accessing the network. Ports with portfast enabled start immediately in the forwarding state. Okay, let's go to the lab notes for step 5. It asks the age of BPDUs at each point in the LAN. So switch 1 is the root bridge, so it should send BPDUs with age 0. That means that switch 2 and switch 3 will age out those BPDUs in 20 seconds, the full max age timer. Let's confirm by doing a packet capture on the switch 1 to switch 2 link. Go to packet capture and click on start. After a few BPDUs arrive, I'll just click on stop. And let's examine the first BPDU. Open the spanning tree protocol message in the frame and look down here. Message age 0, as expected. Now, I want to point out one thing. Notice that there are two BPDUs every 2 seconds, even though there is only one VLAN in the LAN, VLAN 1. One BPDU is sent to 0100/0CCC/CCCD, the multicast MAC address for PVST+. This is sent in the VLAN of the STP instance, VLAN 1 in this case. Because it's the native VLAN, it doesn't have a VLAN tag, but if it was a non-native VLAN, it would be tagged. In addition to that BPDU, it sends a BPDU to 0180C200000, which is the multicast MAC address for IEEE standard STP. This is always sent untagged, and the purpose is for interoperability with switches running standard STP, not Cisco's PVST+. Anyway, that's just a side note. Let's return to BPDU age. Switch 2 should send BPDUs with age 1. To confirm, I'll do a packet capture on the switch 2 to switch 4 link. Start the packet capture, and after getting a few BPDUs, I'll stop it. Let's check any of the BPDUs works. As you can see in the contents of the STP message, switch 2 does indeed send BPDUs with age 1. So switch 4 and switch 5 will age these BPDUs out in 19 seconds, the max age timer minus 1. Then, switch 4's BPDUs to switch 5, and switch 5's BPDUs to switch 6 should be sent with age 2. I'll confirm with a packet capture on the switch 4 to switch 5 link. Click on Start, and let's check the first BPDU. As expected, switch 4 sends the BPDU with age 2. So switch 5 will age BPDUs from switch 4 out in 18 seconds, and switch 6 will do the same for BPDUs from switch 5. Let's return to the lab notes for step 6. It says to change the STP timers of the root bridge, and confirm that other switches are using the new timers. Remember, the timers of the root bridge should determine the timers for the other switches in the spanning tree. So let's go to the CLI of switch 1 and configure those timers. Conf T. First, the hello timer. Spanning tree VLAN 1, hello time, and I'll set it to 1 second. We can confirm this right now with another packet capture. I'll do it on the switch 2 to switch 5 link this time. After starting the packet capture, you can see that BPDUs are sent every second, instead of every 2 seconds. Okay, I'll go back to switch 1. Let's do the forward delay timer next. Spanning tree VLAN 1, forward time, let's set it to something very short, like 4 seconds, which is actually the shortest allowed. To test, I'll go on switch 4, and let's try shutting down its G01 interface, like we did in step 2. Interface G01, shutdown. Wait a couple seconds for the log messages, and then let's re-enable it with no shutdown. So it'll enter the listening state, and then 4 seconds later the learning state, instead of the standard 15. Even though we configured switch 1, not switch 4, switch 4 is using switch 1's forward time. So it went from listening to learning to forwarding in only 8 seconds. Okay, now let's return to switch 1 to configure the max age timer. Spanning tree VLAN 1, max age. Let's set it to the minimum, which is 6 seconds. To test this one, let's once again return to switch 4. I'll shut down G00 again, and see how long it takes G01 to switch its role from designated to root this time, like we saw in step 3. Interface G00, shutdown. So last time it took about 18 seconds before switch 5 aged out switch 4's BPDU, forwarded switch 1's BPDUs to switch 4, and switch 4 G01 became the new root port. But this time it only took 6 seconds. So we have confirmed that the timers configured on the root bridge will be used by the other switches in the spanning tree. Okay, that's all for this lab. In this lab, we tested and confirmed the various STP states and timers that we covered in the lecture video. I hope it was helpful. Thanks for watching. Before finishing this video, let me thank my JCNP level channel members. To become a member, please click the join button under the video. Thanks to Jonathan Makara, Velva Jacob, Funny Dart, George Streeter, Nasir Chowdhury, Devin Suku, Gustavo BR, Marcel Lord, Pavel M, Mr. Erlison, Dragos Hirnea, Zakib Shah, Mayor Salman, Mazen Anderson, Vitaus 194, Gina Lindley, Mark Jackson, Bold 1C1U, Michael Carroll, Gerald Guillaume, Gabriel Braga, Hector Hernandez, Mara Tuba, Roji Kuriakos, Arpad Konivez, 5 Feet, Owad, Daniel Brown, Tricky Mickey 123456, Scott Thompson, Jose Alvarez, Hussein Yavuz, Kevin Hayes, Samuel Tavares, Roger Bratseth, Mustafa Ersoy, Nasser Zahar, Brian Grant, Georgi Gemajev, Kyle, Arlen Plagaria, Dear Diso, Adelson Pereira, Farad 69, Joyce Njoroge, Lucien Stoichitoyu, Madmark 50484, Sean Powell, Alexandru Stratton, Hiago Bicalho, Pieter Kaimov, Abdo Zizo, DMJ2, Kurt Nell, Preeti Dongave, Abu Bakar Berry, Omid Farakesh, Steve Cox, Jasper Yim, Wilmer Romero, Enigma G, Laurent Lam, Pedro Hartman, Ivano Capuano, Jefferson Steelflex, Sinan Sarisinar, Alejandra Okana, Burl Campbell, Abhishek Sahu, Toxic Gio, Daniel Andrade, Vijay Kumar Pili, Jairo Francisco, Dedenoyu Diana, Hamudi Batman, Mike Crumby, Eliel Eliluli, and Dragos George. Sorry if I pronounced your name incorrectly, but thank you so much for your support. Thanks to you and my other supporters, I am able to make these videos and release them for free on YouTube, so I really appreciate the support. Another great way to support the channel is to like the video, leave a comment, subscribe, and most importantly, share this video with others. So if this video was helpful, I'd appreciate it if you did any of those. Thanks for watching.